As a basketball fan growing up in Minnesota, I've watched a lot of KG play. He was my favorite player growing up. I loved to watch him every single game I could. Even when he got traded to Boston, I was so happy to see him win a championship. What I thought separated KG, and what I always tell people to describe KG's game, I say that Kevin Garnett played on the edge of insanity. Even though I feel like KG is a pretty nice guy off the court, and I've heard stories about him, you know, paying for people's meals and, you know, giving turkeys to the people in Minneapolis on Thanksgiving and the foundation and the giving computers to schools. He's done a lot of good stuff, and I think he's a pretty good guy off the court. When he's on the court, I just love the anger and intensity that he plays basketball with. And when I think about KG playing, I think about the movie Dodgeball and that one character, and he's like, you gotta get angry. Sometimes you just gotta get angry. I grew up as a Christian in a good Christian home. I went to a Christian school. You know, I'm a nice guy. But sometimes you gotta get angry. Like, we can't play nice all the time. Sometimes you gotta play with that anger, with that intensity. And yes, in sports, I'm talking about that because you can't just sit back and let everybody throw you around. You gotta get out there and play mad sometimes. But also, in life, you can't just sit back and allow things to happen to you. The devil is coming at you. He is trying to destroy you. Steal, kill, and destroy, the Bible says. And you can't just play nice. You can't just sit back and take everything and say, I'm gonna be this good little Christian boy or girl, and I'm gonna, you know, say nice things and do nice things. Sometimes you gotta get angry. Jesus got angry sometimes. I love the story of Jesus tossing the tables in the temple, because that was this raw emotion of, you're not doing that. You're not selling these things. You're not making a mockery of my Father's house. Sometimes you gotta get mad. I'm not talking about getting mad at people and hurting people and getting violent. This is a righteous anger that Jesus had. It was an anger at the devil and the works of evil. You gotta understand, our war, our battle on this earth is not with people. So don't let people get you mad. Don't get mad at people, don't react in violence. But the Bible says that our battle is not with flesh and blood, right? It's against principalities and powers. It's a spiritual battle. The enemy, the devil, the enemy of your soul is coming at you, and you can't just play nice with him. Sometimes you gotta get mad. But what does that look like to get mad at in the spirit realm? Every time the devil does something to me, I'm gonna identify it and I'm gonna do something right back. So let's say the devil causes pain or sickness in your body or mentally or in your family. Get back at him by serving at a soup kitchen. Or say every time the devil makes me mad, I'm gonna turn on praise and worship music and I'm gonna pray in tongues for an hour. Say every time the devil does this in my life, I'm gonna go evangelizing on the streets and I'm gonna get people saved. I'm gonna spread the gospel. You know how mad are you gonna make the devil? Get back at him, don't just sit there and take it. Do you see hurting and pain and suffering in the world? Get mad at the devil and do something to stop it. Also, get mad at the devil for sin when he tries to put sin and temptation in your life. If there's an addiction in your life that the devil is using to keep you down, every time he pops up that temptation, get mad at, recognize that it's coming from him and get mad at him and defiantly say no. And whether it's to drugs or alcohol or pornography, whatever it is, don't allow the devil to win. Get mad, fight back, say no. I'm not gonna allow this addiction to rule my life, and I'm not gonna allow it to affect other people. I'm not gonna allow this sin in my life to keep me down, to keep me in bondage, when God has given his grace to free me from this. When the devil brings temptation to you, don't just sit back there and say, oh, it's not a big deal. It doesn't really hurt anybody. No, get mad, don't take that. It hurts you. Don't allow the devil to keep you down. Don't allow the devil to keep oppressing you with that sin and that addiction. Don't take that anymore. Allow me to quote DMX real quick. In his song, Lord Give Me a Sign, he said, the devil's trying to find me, so hide me. Hold up, I take that back. Protect me and give me the strength to fight back. I mean, he said a little different because he's DMX. So he had that, like, that gravel, that growl, that in there, you know, that DMX does. But that's such a true statement. A lot of us are like scared of the devil. So we're like, oh, hide me, the devil's coming to get me. It's like, no. Don't hide me, protect me, but give me the strength to fight back. Let me go get him. Let me take it at the devil instead of allowing him to come to me all the time. I'm not gonna put up with this anymore. Some people might tell you, you gotta play nice. Don't get mad, don't get angry. I say get mad, get angry. Sometimes you gotta play with a little bit of anger. You gotta let that passion fuel you. When the devil, the enemy of your soul, tries to steal, kill, and destroy, don't sit back and take it. Get mad and fight back.